What is up, Ultimates? So welcome back to Until Dawn. I fixed the audio, so now, like, all the sound is actually coming through my headphones, so I can put these on, and it will work. Well, it's time for more Until Dawn, guys. Okay. So let's have a quick look at, things. Film, trophy, beach photo, the family portrait. Now, where we were last time, we were going to the cabin. We were in the cabin in the woods with Jessica. Okay, let's go. Let's carry on with the story then.
I was promised my. Michael, I am a lady, and a lady needs a proper romantic setting.
Okay.
A lady would like to cuddle up with her man by a nice cozy fire bathed in atmospheric mood lighting.
Right. It'll get plenty toasty. It's a revenant.
Okay.
Mike, fire and mood lighting.
Yes.
Okay, let's go. So we gotta get mood lighting and mood lighting, and we gotta set the okay, so we gotta turn on the fire. Why can't it just be an electric one?
Unless you want to make out with an ice sculpture, I suggest you get a fire going pronto.
Why can't it just be an electronic fire? Well, that's what I'm doing. Guys, I'm doing that. I don't get it. That's what I'm doing. A gun.
Oh, Jess! Look at this!
Is it a fire?
No, way cooler.
Show the gun scarer. Let's give her a bit a good scare. Get her back from earlier.
Freeze!
I am freezing. I'm gonna smack you on the head if you don't stop pointing that thing at me.
You resisting arrest?
What if that thing is loaded?
Oh, that's a good point.
Michael!
What?
Put it down!
Yes, ma'am. Nothing to see here. Move along.
Maybe we shouldn't have done that. What is over here? Native American myths and legends.
You're lighting a fire, Michael, not writing a novel. How much longer is it gonna take you?
The mother bear has returned.
Looks like we weren't the only ones to meet the friendly neighborhood terror bears.
That does not make me feel any.
I kind of want to check settings. So I can have a look at the side. Oh my god. It's the right stick, yeah.
This'll take care of the mood lighting.
Oh, I had to actually press it down. Did not know that. Hi, Dakari, how are you? I'm just playing Until Dawn. In fact, maybe I should change the title. Guys, I'm gonna quickly change the title of the broadcast.
Just need a match.
Okay, guys. I can't change the title of the broadcast, so this is what I'm going to be doing at the moment. It's a bit annoying. Okay, it is actually worked this time. It actually detects that I am playing Until Dawn. Because earlier it couldn't tell. What's the matter?
Shit.
What, she lost?
Mike!
What?
Oh, crap!
What?
Where is it?
What? What's wrong?
Gone. It is gone, okay?
Jess, slow down. What is gone?
My freaking phone, Sherlock.
Can you find it?
Crap, no. I must have dropped it outside.
Oh, shit.
I can't lose my phone. My parents will kill me.
You can always get a new one.
That's like my fourth one this year.
Okay. Well, I'll have you look for it.
It's gotta be outside.
Yeah, I...
Oh, no.
Don't think we want to go out there right now with the bear. Or whatever it is.
I don't think that's a bear. Yeah, we got matches.
Looky, looky. Who's gonna fire up some nookie?
You've been dying to use that line since we got here, haven't you?
I'm gonna activate the fire in a minute because there might be something around here that can come in useful later on.
Nice. This will lighten up the mood a little.
Yes, it will.
Oh!
Hey, what, are you okay?
What are you doing?
Oh my god.
It's the lights.
I know it's the lights, dummy. You broke them.
It's probably faulty wiring or something.
Hannah.
Faulty wiring.
I've noticed that every single photo of Hannah, it's clearly showing that tattoo on her arm. Don't really care about her tattoo, but like, there's got to be something relevant about that tattoo. I mean, it's in every shot. What is this? Can I read it now? There we go.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh,
these
God.
Guys were inventive. Whoa. I'm not sure if I'm ready for such advanced levels of gameplay.
Okay. Anyway, let's carry on. Do you should... I hope you didn't see that. Hopefully you don't keep seeing that. Getting sent a few messages. I have both to party.
Oh, fucking shit. Fuck shit. What do you think was in there, Mike?
I'm gonna change the volume because I don't think you guys can hear me very well. That's not what I wanted to do. I need to go to settings. Okay. Sound and screen. Okay, guys. I forgot how to turn up my mic volume. So this is what it's going to be like, guys. Sorry if it's a bit quiet. Of course, Takali, my name is Ultimate847 on PSN. Oh, I'm really low in honest. I'm not very honest. Not very honest, Mike. I mean, I'll show you. There, bottom left corner, tattoo. Well, that one doesn't show it. But then this one shows it too. And I think I'm thinking way too into things. I just got this feeling, it just seems like a bit. It seems like, I don't know, the tattoo's just got my attention. Maybe I just like the tattoo, butterfly. Aha, maybe it's a symbol of the butterfly effect.
Man one, fire zero.
Very nice. Bravo.
All right, my lady. What comes next?
I think, well, I wish we had some booze.
If I'd have known that ahead of time.
I don't know, I'm kind of just, I'm not feeling it yet.
Reassure. Yeah, what's wrong?
Am I doing something wrong?
No. I mean, I thought you were one way, but you're kind of another way. Does that make sense? It's not your fault.
Oh, well.
Jess, I really like you. Whoever you think I am, well, just give me a chance, and I will show you what you need.
Well, I am liking your confidence.
Ooh, she likes our confidence.
Mike, the shutters.
What about them?
Close them, please.
There's just no one out there.
I feel like someone's watching us. I don't like it.
Yes, really. It's fine.
I really don't like it.
Okay, shutter.
Oh, God. She's right. She was right. Well, I'm not expecting a jump scare.
Voila. Shutters are shutted. Now, where were we?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I think I'm a little freaked out, and it's hard for me to, like, keep this up, and...
What? Keep what up?
Look, I act all super confident and, like, a total sexy babe and everything, but underneath, I gotta be honest, I'm really kind of insecure.
Oh, she's insecure. You're super hot. Now, let's reassure her.
Jess, you've gotta be kidding.
What?
Oh, no.
You have nothing to be insecure about.
Oh, you have no idea.
Sure I do. You're just like me and everyone else. We're all insecure. But you know how to handle yourself. You might call it a front, but it's real.
Yeah, I guess I do.
Yeah, and that's super fucking hot.
Really?
Yeah, hell yeah it is.
Come here. Maybe I know how to handle you, too.
I am definitely ready to be handled.
Ooh. Oh, now they make... It's time. Oh, we're getting into it. What was that?
Okay, well, go find out now, please.
Oh, God. What? There's snow coming in and wind. Oh my God, it's her phone. The one she lost. No way.
It's your phone.
What? How is it my phone?
I don't know. It just came through the window.
Oh, for fuck's sake. God damn it.
What?
Those goddamn assholes probably followed us out here to fuck with us and just when we were getting down to business.
What's she doing? Oh no!
Hey! Yeah, bricks!
Oh no.
That means you! I know! You're out there. The fuck are you trying to
do? Oh god. Oh, God.
And it's gonna be hot. So enjoy it, because I know we're going to.
Go on, Jessica, get back inside the cabin. Lock it. Oh, my God. Okay, Ducati. Oh, my God. Swimming's got Jess.
Do you really think the girls were...
That hand, though, it did not look human.
I don't know if I wish they were or if I wish they weren't.
I guess we should find out.
Ducati, I got your friend request. I'll accept it later.
Josh looked really freaked out at the seance.
He looked like he was keeping it together, but...
Do you think we shouldn't have mentioned his sisters?
I mean, it's why we came back up here.
Yeah, but not to, like, have a seance.
Maybe true.
We went too far. Damn it.
Okay, let's just keep moving. I don't know. Oh, God. I want to find out what's... Okay.
Are you okay?
All so. That. Look.
What?
There was something behind the books. What is that?
It's a button.
Is it a button?
Why would there be a button?
That's a good question.
Should I push it?
That's what buttons were for, I guess. Oh, panel opens. Head explodes.
Are we like in a movie right now?
If we are, I hope it's a rom-com.
Leave it to the Washingtons to have secret passages in their house.
I mean, maybe they didn't even know. This place is super old.
So, should we take a look?
Yeah, after you.
No. You go.
Gee, thanks.
Okay. Whoever has the candle is the one I control. Oh my God, a spider. Don't like spiders. Is a picture of Hannah and Beth. And there we go. Once again, the tattoo's showing. I think I'm just overthinking it.
What?
Whoa, is this...
What did you find?
I will take them and bleed them like pigs and rip their soft white skin off. Fucking 16 years. 16 years I waited for pretty little Hannah and Beth. Oh, God.
Holy cow.
She needs to know. Like, the more everyone knows that there's something going on, like, the more cautious they'll be. And hopefully that will keep everyone alive. Because that's what I'm aiming for.
I don't want to freak you out, but look at this.
What? Chris, what is that?
I think this might be what the spirit board wanted us to find.
The clue?
Yeah, it's a letter.
Let me see it.
It's a threat.
Chris, this is serious. We need to find Josh right now.
Okay, let's go find Josh. Oh no.
What was that?
It was a door that opened on its own.
Do you think someone was actually after Hannah and Beth?
If so, that would be really messed up.
So, I've just been thinking about something I saw earlier with Sam.
What?
There was like this wanted poster, like full on Western style, you know?
Oh yeah.
And Sam really thought there was someone following her around.
So what you're saying, there's some criminal up on the mountain with us?
And then I found that crazy psycho letter.
Chris, if this is your way of trying to make me feel better, you're fired.
You hear that?
That was Josh.
Coming from the kitchen.
Josh!
Oh no! My god, Ashley!
Ashley, what's going on? Let me in! Ashley! Are you okay? I'm gonna... Ash? Ash!
Oh my gosh. Who was that? But then Josh must be in trouble too because we heard him scream. Oh no. Oh no.
I'm going to show you some pictures of people that you have come to know.
Okay.
But maybe you don't like them as much as you pretend to.
So what's this about?
Well, this is an exercise in honesty. Tell me which person from each pair you like the most. Take your time. Your answers are important.
Okay. I prefer Sam. I prefer Matt. Ooh. I do prefer Chris. Ooh, Mike or Jessica. This one's hard. I mean, Mike has been a bit of a douche at times, and he cheated on Jessica for Emily. I keep yawning and I need to stop. But so yeah, I'm gonna say Jessica. Okay, let's carry on. Emily and Josh. I prefer Josh. I prefer Mike.
So tell me, in this little game you're playing so diligently, who is it that you most dislike?
I'm not to know. Emily or Ashley? I don't know. I mean, Emily can be a bit bitchy, but sometimes I find Ashley quite annoying. And so far, as I've seen in the game, Ashley has been the biggest wimp. So I'm going to go with Ashley.
I guess you think she's getting what she deserves.
What?
You think the way you feel about her justifies the terrible trauma she is about to go through.
What?
Now, why would you think that? Oh. Time's up. Come back soon. We'll talk again. Perhaps in the meantime, you can try to figure that one out for yourself.
Trauma. But aren't they all going to go through trauma? I mean, it's Until Dawn. I mean, so far, I'd say Josh has gone through the most trauma because it's his sisters.
Hold on!
There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. Apparently, he had warned them against pursuing their construction project in Blackwood Pines and claimed the land was sacred to his forefathers.
S.
I.
S. T.
Sister?
Ask it whose sister.
Josh, it's gotta be.
Which sister is it then?
Ah!
Run!
Oh. Oh. Oh my god.
Ash!
Come here. Maybe I know how to handle you too.
Can I remember this part? Can I remember all this? Episode 4. Malevolence. Hopefully I'm saying that right.
Jessica! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Okay.
Jess!
I'm guessing there's going to be quick time events, so you know, I got to be ready this time. Wrist shortcut. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Yes! Get in there!
Jessica! Jessica!
No, look at what's grabbing her! Look at what's grabbing her! Look at what's dragging her! Look at what's dragging her! Why doesn't he just look at what's dragging her? No, go around. Okay, hurry up, Mike. Maybe we should have jumped down.
Keep going, keep going.
Oh no. Oh my god.
Okay.
Oh god. There's no way I'm gonna be able to save her. I did that. I shouldn't. I didn't fail that. I click circle. Okay, guys. My problem was with the that I kept getting circle and square mixed up. I know that triangles are up and X is down, but I keep getting the circle and the square mixed up. Jessica.
Jessica!
Hurry up, Mike. Run! Jessica might die. Aww. I think because I messed up all those quick time events, she's probably gonna die. Sorry, guys, I'm not the best at quick time events.
Jessica!
Where is she? Hurry up. Come on, Mike, run!
Jessica!
Oh no. Because I messed that one up.
No! Oh, God! Jessica! Oh, Jessica. No, Jessica.
Okay. Now the whole place is collapsing.
What the fuck?
That thing clearly dropped her. Okay, let's carry on. Hopefully that killed something. But that whatever I saw up there just then, that didn't look human. Quick, we gotta practice those quick time events. Yes. I'm guessing that quick time events are gonna like decide whether a lot of characters will live or die. So I'm gonna go, I gotta practice with them.
Come to Papa.
Flip, I click the circle. I need to practice with these. Gonna climb, jump again. Here we go. We did it, but I clicked circle again. I'm not the best at these quick time events, guys. Who? Was there someone there? Oh, there he is.
What the?
Oh, I wasted my bullets. Oh, sorry, I had one bullet and I shot that, that thing that was looking down.
No. Shit.
Okay, this is the way to go.
Okay. Take it easy. Not so fast, cowboy.
Let's carry on.
That's it.
What was that? There was something just there. Screw that. Flip. What was that thing? Okay, guys. At the moment, like, every single light, like, I've got no light source except the TV, so it's proper horror, this is. Yeah, let's have a look at this. Let's have a look at all of this. Honesty's down, charitable's funny's down, bravery's up. But it's like, the bravery's, it's up, but it's bad. It's so much, then I'm too brave, basically. And I think that the Jess one's red because she's dead. Kind of rhymes. It's red because she's dead. No, I don't know, guys. Anyway, let's have a look at what else I've got. Okay, the Native American book and the threatening letter. Okay, well, let's carry on then. So we've killed Jessica. We've killed off a character already, guys. I think my problem with Until Dawn is I don't know.
Is that place?
My problem with Until Dawn is I don't know the controls. Like, the problem with the quick time events is if they were on Xbox, I know, because I know what the four buttons are, like Y, X, B, and A. But I'm new to the PS controls. I've never had a PlayStation before.
Ashley?
I'm getting the Y and X ones, but the square and circle, I keep getting them mixed up.
Ash. Ash. The fuck?
Blood.
Oh, shit. No. Ash!
Please don't say Ash is dead. Or Josh.
Ashley! Ashley! Anyone out there, Ashley?
Oh no. More blood. Where does this path even go to?
Ash. Ash. Ash.
I gotta look out for totems.
Ashley?
Any totems around?
Ash.
I thought that was a totem. That, I swear that's a totem. Guess not.
Ashley! Ash, I'm here. Where are you? God damn.
Flip.
Please, help me.
I'm coming, Ash. Just keep talking to me. What happened?
Chris, tie me up. I can't.
What?
Chris, are you there?
Hello. And thank you all for joining me.
Wake up.
Tonight.
What?
We're gonna conduct a little experiment, sort of test. Now for this experiment, we'll need the cooperation of our two test subjects, Joshua and Ashley.
What?
But
oh my god, this
we're
is
gonna
so...
need one more brave participant to help decide which subject will live and which will die.
What?
Oh my god, oh my god.
I'm keeping Josh alive.
Get out of here.
Please, 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 everyone calm down. It's all very simple. Christopher, you will find a lever placed directly in front of you. All you have to do is choose who you will save.
I don't know.
Oh, no. Please, this can't be happening.
Shit, no!
Oh, my God, oh God, this isn't right!
Okay, this is gonna be okay. Oh, dude, buddy. Let's
oh
just
my
think
God.
About this for
Chris,
a minute.
You can't let me.
Just give me a second. I can't think straight. Just
Save Josh or save Ashley. I'm gonna save Josh.
God, Ash. I'm sorry.
Chris, please. Oh God. This is insane.
So I'm guessing the one that I go to is the person that it will go to. So if I go to here, hopefully.
I see.
No.
Save.
Wait, no.
No, it's a mistake. It's not
what I meant. Josh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean for this to happen.
But that's not what I wanted.
Why would you do
no.
this? Oh, God, what did I do?
I bent the wrong way. That's not what I wanted to do.
I'm coming, Ash. I'm gonna get you. I'm letting you down. Shh, stop, please. Come on. Let's get
no.
you down. Come on, we're gonna get you out of here.
No.
We gotta go, okay?
Oh. I've already killed off two characters. Now I'm not liking this. Killed off two characters. Can't believe this. You said that Chris said that he would save Josh, but then he didn't. Be her hero. Resisted Mike's advances. Okay, well, Jessica's dead now. Mike stumbled when he was chasing after Jessica. Mike was too late. Jessica was dead. Oh, no. We'll have a look at that later on.
Chris! Ashley!
Blood? Whose blood is that, Ash?
Are you okay?
Chris, what happened?
Josh, what? Dude?
He's dead.
Wait,
not
what?
Right in front of us, man.
What are you talking
there's
about?
There's a maniac.
Maniac?
Oh my god, we gotta get out of here.
I don't understand what happened.
There's a maniac, and he was, there was a saw, and it was either him or Ash, and I don't know what
oh
to
god.
Do.
Oh god.
Come on. Right through him and spilling out fucking everywhere.
What?
What? And I killed him.
What, Chris?
I killed him. It was my fault.
No, no, this is insane. We need to go get some help.
I cut right in half.
We're gonna figure this out.
There's only eight characters. I've killed off a quarter of the characters already.
And we should look for the others.
Mike and Jess are off 69ing each other, and who knows where Sam is.
I think she's in the lodge.
Fine, you're right. Get everyone else together, but if there's a maniac running around, I think we need to get some help too, right? Not just wait around.
But what about...
Why are we still talking about this? Let's go!
Oh my god. What is wrong with this therapist? I think I should be giving him therapy.
Hello again.
Hello.
Things are getting pretty tense out there, aren't they?
Yes.
Is the night going the way you hoped it would?
No.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
I see.
I killed Jess and Josh.
Do you think that these poor people are getting what they deserve?
No, I just said it's not going well. Who are you or what you want? What you want?
I'm trying to help you. And this game you're playing, you understand that it's not good for you. It's not good for anyone. And I can't say that you're showing much loyalty in the way you're playing.
I am, I think. God.
Do you intend to continue with this elaborate self-indulgence?
You're freaking me out. Yeah, you're freaking me out.
Do you even believe that I...
Oh, a real therapist wouldn't have, like, all of this in his office, so no, you don't exist.
The heart of the problem, it all comes down to this. Can you really tell the difference anymore? I doubt it.
There's something going on about this game. Well, we're going to have a look at the bonus content, Making a Scene, and the Science of Fear. Okay, let's have a look at Making a Scene first.
Hi, this is Lee Robinson, production designer on Until Dawn. The production design for Until Dawn started with the great teen horror script that sets the characters in a Canadian winter mountain lodge, being a contemporary setting with visual clues derived from classic films of that genre, such as Hitchcock's Psycho and Stanley Kubrick's Shining. The storyboards are vital to the production design as it allows the designer to understand the scale of the environments to be made and the detail that would be seen to create the atmosphere of a horror. This took us into concepts that took these storyboards further, visualizing the world through the color palette, the lighting, tone, and the mood, and developing key locations such as the lodge, the cable car stations, the forests themselves, the wilderness. As you can see, the environments and atmospheres changed quite a bit from warm and inviting to cold and threatening. The Millionaire's Mountain Lodge was a key example. It was designed to be made from nearby stone and timber, embedding it into the landscape, with a contrasting and contemporary interior needing to be opulent and extravagant. We created dark and claustrophobic corridors with ominous and large open spaces, almost cathedral-like in size, and with huge structures to silhouette and dwarf the characters within, providing a labyrinth to explore and wander. Each character was developed with a strong visual identity in mind, with contrasting colours, tones and silhouettes to identify them, each to have their own texture, pattern and shape, so that when they were lined up, you could always identify them. The costume designs allowed a range of clothes that would suit them for the cold winter weather, but also have an element of style and individualism, so that the audience could look at them and relate, recognizing themselves within them.
A lady would like to cuddle up with her man by a nice cozy fire bathed in atmospheric mood lighting.
Right. It'll get plenty toasty once we're rubbing up against each other.
Mike.
Yeah.
Fire and mood lighting.
Yes.
Working with the lighting artists, we really brought the look and feel of the world together, and this required a thorough understanding of the visual language of teen horror. A key scene was where all the characters emerge out of the rear of the lodge chasing Hannah. A contrast is evident straight away from the exterior wilderness to the warmth of the lodge. The attention to character lighting here is through the bounce and rim lighting, accented colours and composition, creating characters that come from the dark into the light and back again with an emotional effect.
Guys! There's someone outside. What the hell?
Hannah!
Okay.
What's going on? Where's my sister going?
Oh, it's fine. She just can't take a joke.
It was just a prank, Han.
It was just a prank, Han. Okay, well, let's have a look at the next one. The Science of Fear. Let's have a look, then.
Until Dawn is a game that's full of horror. And one of the things we decided to do early on was to take a scientific approach to how scary it was. So we did experiments on people and we measured their responses to the game. We've created a test area. It's as close to a home setup as we can get it. We've recruited ordinary people to play the game and we've left them to play it on their own.
You're turning the light off.
The only difference is it's rigged with cameras and microphones that relay the data through to the next room where people are watching them play.
A bit like me.
Used for biometric testing. It measures the player's emotional response. It's called a galvanic response sensor. It makes contact with the user's skin and it measures the electrical conductivity across their skin. It's the same principle as an old-fashioned lie detector. When you're stressed, you sweat a little, very sensitive, and picks up tiny changes if the player's feeling anxious or scared.
Okay.
That data's fed back to a testing team, comes through as a graph.
I'm so sorry.
There we go. Guys, it's like watching me play.
No point testing one or two people, you have to test a lot of people.
Yeah. True.
When we have a scare that's consistently has a measurable emotional response, then we knew it was good. If it didn't have that, it goes back to the team for improvement. The data doesn't tell us what's wrong with the scare, it only tells us if it's working or not.
Okay.
You hear that too,
right? Josh.
Here we have a chapter relatively early in the game.
Weirdly regular.
Nothing regular about it.
We have to create tension and anxiety in the player so they are ready to receive the scare.
Hi.
You have to give the player time to recover, to cool down, to calm down, and then start building the tension again before we do the next scare.
Hey.
What?
Hey.
Okay, that's all cool and all, but I'm going to get back to the game now. Previously on Until Dawn.
That could be a lot of things. None of them nice.
Quit it.
Here's our one-way ticket to the spirit realm.
I've just been through enough spooking for one night, okay? I see a hot bath in my crystal ball. So have fun.
Lord, you do this! Jessica! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Oh yeah, we killed Jess. Shit.
There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain. Could he be hiding there?
Mm-mm. A Episode 5, Dread. 6 hours until dawn.
Jesus. That's not good. That's really not good.
Mike, the sanatorium grounds. Let's carry on. You know, I think I'm gonna kill everyone off. I probably am. I think I'm really bad at quick time events, and that's the truth. Okay, let's carry on. Two dogs. And a guy. Okay. It says security pass required, so guess I need a security pass. No way. Okay. Around here, anyway. This way. Oh! I never knew this space was here. Okay, admin. Let's have a look over here. The Blackwell Sanatorium. Admin. I'm an admin. I'm proper admin. I can be the admin anywhere, guys. If you want me to be your admin, then I'm a great admin. Morgue. Do we have to go to the morgue? Let's go this way. I don't want to go to the morgue. Morgues are creepy. Okay, let's carry on. Let's go to the morgue. Medical notes. One of these guys actually tried to bite me. I'm going to report to Dr. Bowen. 12 miners after the collapse of the miners was can rescue. Sanatoriums. What? After being trapped for 30. There's something going on. And that thing that we saw after Jess died, that was not human. And then there's the psycho that killed Josh. I think we're dealing with more than one threat here, guys. Why are there crows everywhere?
Oh, shit. Crows.
Take it for ourselves, then. What are we looking for? Oh yeah, we're looking for that. Oh my god, Wolfie's here. That's what I'm gonna call them. We gotta call them Wolfie 1 and Wolfie 2. Whichever Wolfie we come into contact with first is Wolfie 1. Yeah, this is a trap. Air trap. Told you guys. Oh god. Come on, let's do what we. Amputate fingers. No, we gotta try and open the bear trap. Oh god, something's coming. Bear trap. No, amputate the fingers.
Oh shit.
Oh god. Oh, shit. Just do it, Mike. Just do it. Oh, God.
Okay.
Oh god. Another 10. Oh no, it's not. Attacked by inmate Fatal. What? Someone attacked his throat. Another inmate. Wait, where are all these bodies? They're all gone. Severe. I can't read some of this. Why are we opening all of them? Well, I guess I'm the one doing it. Oh my god, this one's got a body. Oh god.
Sick. That's what I say.
Oh my god. That's... Now I can get into the chapel. Okay, let's carry on then. Do we have to go back now?
This place just gets better and better.
That strange school, yeah. That doesn't... That looked like that thing that was in the mines. And that body, that didn't look normal. That didn't look quite... It looked kind of human. But it didn't look human. That looks like it was, like, some way transforming into what I saw after Jess died. Okay, there we go. Let's carry on. Merry Christmas, David. How are you? I'm just playing a bit of a new horror game on Christmas. Wolfie, stay back. Okay, I'm in the chapel. There's that man. Okay, we got... I'm going to call him the Stranger. So we got the Maniac, the Stranger, Wolfie, and that weird thing. Yeah, that's what I'm going to call that thing that we saw after Jess died. That weird thing. I'm getting ready for these quick time events because that's what made me fail in saving Jessica. That's what killed off Jessica, the quick time events, because I didn't do them. Want to hit the dog? Maybe we could be friends, Wolfie.
Easy, boy. Easy.
Oh, Wolfie's friendly. Easy. Wolfie, please be friendly.
That's a good boy.
Just approach him.
That's a good boy. That's right.
We're making new friends.
Like that? Yeah.
Wolfie! Yeah,
likes a little loving, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We'll get Jessica, new babe, Wolfie. Anyway. man's best friend, Mike made a friend. Mike didn't kick the wolf, Mike made a friend. Mike hacked off his own fingers. Mike still had a usable machete. Chris said that he didn't, that he would save Josh, but then he didn't. Yeah. Something for later. And then we got Jessica. We got rid of her. I didn't want to kill Jessica. Okay, good, Wolfie. Good, Wolfie.
You like that? Yeah. Everyone likes a little loving, right?
Okay, so we're friends with Wolfie now. There was also another Wolfie. Let's call them Wolfie and Wolf. So that's Wolfie. The other one's Wolf because we haven't really met him. He's not worthy of the title Wolfie yet because we don't know whether he's like mean. Don't know whether he's gonna try and bite our head off.
So he's a smoker.
Oh, David. You have three people left. Well, I've already killed off Jessica and Mike. And no spoilers, please. Bones. We can give Wolfie a bone.
This will keep the wolves fed and happy.
Let's go give this to Wolfie. Wolfie! Okay. Jess is dead. Jessica is dead, now Wolfie is bae. Wolfie!
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Easy, boy. Easy.
Bet Wolfie like that. Okay.
So, what have we here?
Okay. Can't reach it. I need that gun. Aha, pull this out. That will fall. Get the gun. Cool, David. So your PC, is it like good enough to run Planet Coaster? Because I got that game. I bought it, but then I couldn't run it. Look, I'm out found dead. Liars. 14 missing in the mountains. Bigfoot sighted. American girls died. American girls. Does that mean, is he talking to Hannah about Hannah and Beth? Sighting. Father died. Sighting. I think this guy is trying to figure out, like, what killed Jessica and Hannah and Beth. Just blow it open. Cool, David. Straight in here. I I don't even know where I'm supposed to be going. I'm playing this game in the dark, by the way. This is the way.
Of course, locked. Okay.
Shoot it. Oh God. Flammable. Oh yeah, this game is not for winter evenings like Christmas. But oh my God. So is Mike dead now? What's he doing? Did he just like lock Emily and Matt out?
Hey, it's locked. The hell, who did that? Then there's some seriously uncool shit going on up here tonight.
He's locked them out. Oh God.
I can't believe Josh is dead.
I can't believe how he died.
No, I mean, what if they were wrong?
What?
Maybe we should have checked the shed to see if it was really true.
I don't know. There are some things that once you see them, you can never unsee them.
Yeah, I guess, but some things you have to see for yourself.
I'll take their word for it.
Oh yeah, same, I probably would.
Look, an axe. I feel better with an axe.
Same, me too.
Oh, what now? This is locked, Matt. We'll break the door down, will ya?
Whoa, wait a second. We start smashing shit down, he's gonna hear us.
Look, you got any better suggestions?
He's already watching us on security cameras, so...
Look!
What?
The window.
That's great, Matt. I can just about fit my lip balm through that little slot.
Oh, come on.
You will never fit through there, big guy.
Help Emily through the window or smash the door. Well, he's already watching us on security. And if I help Emily through, then it will split us up. So I'm going to smash down the door.
Okay, fine. Here goes. I'm going to huff, and I'm going to...
Shh, just do it!
There we go.
To Chris and Ash and Josh?
He's gotta know this is the only way back.
Don't say that.
Look, the cable car's all the way out there.
Well, I mean, that's not far, right? You can jump it?
Jump that!
But not that good.
Billy, thanks for the follow. I really appreciate it.
Jump that. What are we gonna do?
I don't know.
Like, we'd be able to jump that.
I think they knew exactly what they were doing.
What's this? We're gonna hang the maps back on the wall. Cable car.
Someone really did a number on this joint.
Such a mess. This place was barely in working condition before, and now?
Hey, look! Fire tower.
Hey, Magellan, maybe we should get the cable car working and take this show on the road, huh?
Hmm. so many dies.
Unfollow.
Unfollow. Guys, please don't unfollow.
There's gotta be something we can do.
All ears.
Look at all this crap. There's gotta be something useful in here, right?
What's that? There's got to be something we can do. Could we go to the radio tower?
Great, that's like totally...
gross?
No, just creepy.
True. Okay. Well, at the moment, we kind of... what is this one that's glinting on the floor? Why can't I have a look at that? I don't know, but I need to... I have no idea what I'm supposed to do right now. Aha! This is what I'm supposed to do.
Great. No keys, no cable car. So, back to square one.
What about the fire tower on the map you found?
Well, I guess it's an option.
Oh, maybe it has a radio or something. I mean, it would, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would, actually.
Probably, yeah.
Matt, we gotta get to that radio.
Yeah, we do need that radio.
We can use the radio to call for help. Somebody's gotta pick up the signal.
On the same page. Okay. Medical notes. Got loads of stuff here. Anyway, let's carry on.
Oh, well, someone's learning to play by the rules.
What rules?
What rules?
Rule number one, Emily is always right. Rule number two, nothing else matters because Emily is always right.
What? The rules. Be careful you don't fall to your death.
What's cooking? Good looking?
Getting us out of here, Mr. Meat for Brains.
There we go. We gotta be careful though. We could die.
Ah! Emily!
I always get the square and the circle mixed up. I'm so glad she didn't die there.
Sorry about that, Em. You are okay, right?
Okay. Okay, easy now.
Carry on then.
You know, I'm lucky to be alive, No thanks to you.
Jeez, Em, I tried to grab you.
Good effort, Matt.
I'll do better next time. I promise.
Next time?
I mean...
next time. Okay, let's carry on.
What if it doesn't work?
What?
The radio.
It'll work.
But if it doesn't, we need a plan.
Maybe we can just climb down.
Climb down what?
The mountain.
Are you serious?
What's the big deal? It's not like it's floating in the sky.
It might as well be. It's pitch black out.
Hey,
true.
Hopefully we won't have to.
You think the psychopath is just gonna give up and run away?
No. But maybe we should find a safe spot. Pull up, wait it out. It'll be a lot easier to figure this all out in the morning.
True.
As long as we don't hide in the lodge, that's where he expects us to go.
But where else is there apart from the lodge? The radio tower, maybe? And the cable car station and the sanatorium. The cable car station's wrecked. And the radio tower. The radio tower might be an alright spot. But, the lodge, yeah. I mean, the lodge, as she said, he probably expects it. And the sanatorium. Probably not there. However, then, look, everyone could meet Wolfie. What's that all about? I actually want to have a look at my totem progress. So I missed a fortune. I think I've missed like a load of totems. I wasn't really looking. I forgot all about the totems. Well, loads of new posters. No, not posters, new clues. Oh yeah, was that the axe that was supposed to be here? Interesting. Look at all of Matt's relationships. Every single one but Emily's gone down. Oh my god.
Unless you plan on catching me this time, I prefer not to spend my evening plummeting to my death off a snowy clifftop.
This is where Hannah and Beth died.
What is that?
I don't know.
Jesus!
Oh no, he's watching her take a bath. Turn around, Sam.
Hello? Guys? What are you doing out there? Creepy. Okay.
Hmm. Let's go downstairs.
Pete's sakes, my clothes, really?
Oh no.
Every one of you did this is off my Christmas list. Seriously, not cool, guys. Not cool at all.
Sam? I think you kind of missed Christmas a bit late.
Josh? What the hell?
Oh god. What's in here? No, I'm done. I'm going back to explore a bit. I'm going to have a look this way first. This game, though, it just gets ya. That's locked. Isn't that where I just came from? Did I just lock it behind myself? Oh, well, there wasn't anything here anyway. Great. I never really liked that clock. Ever. Maybe Chris, some of the locked doors from earlier are going to be open
Mike,
now.
Mike, Emily, this is really getting out of hand, okay? It was all very funny, haha. Look at Sam walking around in a towel, but now I just really want this to be over, all right? You had enough?
Sam, I don't think it was your friends that put you in this towel. May have been someone else.
Can I have my clothes back now, or am I supposed to hang out in a towel for the rest of the weekend?
Wasn't...
towel it is then.
What's up with that door? That was closed earlier, but now I just can't even go near it. That was locked earlier. Okay then. I'll just walk back downstairs. She looks scared. Oh, it's Hannah, Sam, Mike and Emily. Ready for senior prom, Hannah, Sam, Mike and Emily.
Okay, if you were trying to freak me out, guess what? You succeeded.
Well, I mean, that one I just got. Yep, the tattoo showing again. There's something important about this tattoo, guys, I'm sure. Might just be stupid. Cinema room.
The hell are you guys? Wow, this is weird.
Oh no.
Hey, guys, come on! Oh, I'm done with this! I really don't appreciate the silent treatment here!
Hello, Samantha. Looking for me? I don't think you'll have much luck by looking, Samantha. You're only going to see what I want you to see. And I have quite a lot to show you.
What is going on?
Open your eyes.
Oh my God.
She's quite beautiful, isn't she?
Oh no.
What are you doing out there?
A beautiful bathing bird. Do you think she has any idea what lies ahead? Do you think these were the last happy moments of this creature's life?
Why are you showing this to me?
Why are you watching?
Josh!
How does it make you feel?
Oh!
Oh my God, what did you do?
I'm going to give you 10 seconds. 9.
No,
8.
No.
Oh, no.
7.
Please, no!
Sam.
Oh my God, he's got a needle, for the vase.
Shit.
Jump, there's no point in hiding there. Come on. Keep running.
Are you kidding me? No handle?
Pull this. Sandal. Okay. Keep going. How is that towel still on? I said we stay hidden, stay low cover. Hello. Oh, here he is.
Here, little kitty. Here, pussy.
Butterfly effect update. Sam, unharmed, healed successfully. There we go.
Fuck!
Yes, run or hide. Sam made all the right choices during the chase. Oh God.
Well, that certainly didn't go according to plan, now did it?
His room's back to normal!
Brilliant plotting, and yet in a crucial moment you are foiled by your own inadequacies.
I got a trophy, the psychopath.
You has consequences.
I got another one, scream tool.
You think this mistake won't have repercussions? What you do, and what you say, causes things to change. Yes. All the good work we did exploring the source of your fear. And you've just gone and used it for ill. Your overwhelming fear of isolation. You have turned it against these people who you so desperately want to torment. Has it been worth it?
Who are we? Wait a minute. So, in these therapy things, do we play as the psycho? God. Plot twist. Updates and collectibles. I've seen everything. Oh, there's a new one here. It's the butterfly effect. Not butterfly effect, the totem. Yeah, Ashley opens the door and lets Chris in. What's that supposed to be? Bonus content. 1,000 pages. Let's have a little look at the bonus content then.
Hi, Larry.
Hey, Graham.
Hi, my name is Graham Resnick. I'm a filmmaker, writer, director, sound designer, and I started working with Larry Fessenden about 10, 15 years ago through my friend Ty West, who I grew up with, and have done a lot of sound design with on his films. And he was producing Ty's films at the time, and Ty introduced me to Larry. Larry produced my first feature, and we've written together on several projects.
My name is Larry Fessenden. I'm a filmmaker. I run Glass Eye Picks, which is an independent production company out of New York. We make indie movies, a lot of scary movies as well. I got a call to audition to write this video game. And I called my pal Graham Resnick because Graham is a gamer. And while I thought I could offer something to the idea of writing this multi-branching story, I knew that I would want Graham's expertise as a lover of gameplay, since I guess games were started. So
and just as a lover.
And as a lover, yes. Just why there's so many sex jokes in the in the game.
There was one Italian website that did say the Larry Fessenden and Graham Resnick, the two lovers behind Until Dawn.
Come here. Maybe I know how to handle you too.
I am definitely ready to be handled.
So I wanted Graham by my side. Yeah, and we got the gig, and it's been an amazing ride.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh my God, she's taking her shirt off.
There it was, the tattoo again.
Oh my God. Matt, what are you doing here?
Hannah. I'm sorry, Hannah. It's all got out of hand, but...
So in the game, the basic setup is that a year prior to the game's start, all these kids had gone up to a ski lodge that was owned by the parents of one of the kids, or a couple of the kids, and some of the teenagers played a prank on some of the other teenagers, and a terrible tragedy occurred when a few of them, two sisters, ran out into a blizzard, and were never seen from again.
Oh yeah. I remember
so
this.
Now, a year later, this is kind of torn apart, this group of friends. They've gone through some trials and tribulations in the past year. The brother of the two girls has had a lot of psychological issues, and to kind of help him cope and help them all get over it, they all return to the lodge a year later, back up on the mountain. And the idea is to get over it, but...
The healing does not begin.
Yeah, and these kids are all trying to find themselves. They've been through a trauma, but in general, they're just teenagers trying to figure out who they are. So they're all kind of falling into the patterns, the stereotypes, the characters they see on TV and in the movies.
I think we were very interested in taking genre tropes and kind of making them sort of refresh them.
Dad said it'd just be us this weekend.
We're familiar with how slasher movies work. Most people have seen some horror movies, and we have established notions and preconceptions about the roles of the players in horror movies and how they talk and how they get killed and how they have sex. And to bring you into the game that way and then subvert a lot of those expectations is kind of our goal.
They're haunted by some incident that happened in their past, which I think you pretty much figure out that that's going to have a role in their interaction. Yeah, so I think what was fun was we take some sort of stock characters and we try to give them some shape, but at least at the beginning they're recognizable in the way of groups of friends. There's, you know, the jock and the and the bitchy girl and the rivalries between everyone. And
oh my gosh. And really fun characters too. Like these, it's, we just had so much fun living in the minds of these characters through writing the script.
What do you think?
Jesus!
You know, it was fun. I think we were looking to get that kind of banter that you see both in movies, but also that you absolutely have with friends. And
okay, well. Now we're just gonna resume it then. Let's just carry on. Previously on Until Dawn.
Stop it! You can't do this! Please!
Oh my god, we gotta get out of here.
I don't understand what happened.
There's a maniac!
This is insane. We need to go get some help. Hello? Guys?
Hello, Samantha. Looking for me?
We should look for the others.
Mike and Jess are off 69ing each other, and who knows where Sam is.
I think she's in the lodge.
Why are we still talking about this? Let's go!
Hey, look! Fire tower.
Matt, what is that?
I don't know.
Okay, let's go. Episode 6, Psychosis.
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
Calm. Calm, huh? Let's stay calm.
Relax. They're just deer. They just wanna check us out, is all.
No, Matt. They're gonna hurt us.
What is Emily doing back there?
Just walk slow. It's okay.
I'm not gonna kill the deer. Butterfly effect update. In self-defense, Matt and Emily escape the threat. Matt walked calmly through the herd. Matt and Emily escape the threat and scathed. Okay, let's carry up. Let's carry on up the path. Why are there so many crows? It's crows everywhere.
If we do manage to get someone on the radio,
we will.
Then we tell them we need help. What do we do while we wait?
We go back to the lodge and get everyone else.
Oh God, not the lodge. We should stay here in case whoever it is needs to get back in touch with us.
Let's get that radio working first.
Hey, let's get up to the radio tower.
Oh, that's freaking bright!
No kidding!
I can't see, what is that?
It's just a security light. Motion sensor, probably.
Okay, let's go. Wait, what's that? Can I go back down? I think I saw a totem. What was that? let's carry on. Let's get to the top of here then. More windy because you're higher up. Let's go.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
Oh, no power. Let's look around.
So, no power.
Missing Hannah Washington.
Sorry, Hannah. You're still missing.
After tonight, their disappearance is starting to make more sense.
True. But I don't think it was the maniac that killed Hannah and Beth. I mean, the stranger was there when they died, but I think it was that thing from earlier. You know, when Jess died? What is this? Emergency flare? Yes, please.
Go.
No, we'll give it to Matt.
Let's go.
What did you do that for?
Some attention. Hopefully someone who's not a psychopath.
Yeah.
Shouldn't have wasted that, Matt. I really want to keep everyone alive. Or everyone that we have left.
Fuck yeah, here we go! Okay, 4-1 for Matt and Emily.
I want to get out of this with at least 5 survivors. Beth. Over.
Hello. Oh my god. Thank god. We need help, please.
Hello, is
someone trying to contact us? This is the Park Ranger Service for Blackwood County. We're not getting your signal very well. Please speak slowly and clearly. Over.
Please, 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 please help. Oh my God, we're stuck on Blackwood Mountain, and there's a maniac.
That is not slowly and clearly, Emily.
I'm unable to understand what you're saying.
We need help, please.
Hello? Can you please identify yourself? Over.
My name is Emily. Okay, let's comply.
Oh my God, okay. My name is Emily. Hello?
You're not coming through clearly. Please repeat. Over.
We're on Blackwood Mountain by the ski lodge. There's a killer and he's after us. He's already killed one of our friends. Oh God, please help.
Oh God.
It's a motion sensor. Probably a fucking deer.
I read you, ma'am. Please do not leave your position. We will send out helicopters to get you as soon as the storm has subsided.
What? When? How long?
Dawn, at the earliest? Not until dawn.
Until dawn. Oh God. Whatever that was, it's gone. I think. Oh no. Oh no. Oh my God.
Emily!
Oh my God.
Me.
Jesus,
shit!
Tell me they're dead.
Oh,
Matt isn't. What about Emily? My goal is to keep 5 people alive. And if Emily's dead, then I can't let any more die. That thing behind you.
Get me out of here!
No, we're not gonna bring up the whole mic thing. We'll be sportive.
Emily, you're upset. You need to calm down. You're gonna be fine.
Ah, stop talking! I can't take it!
Stop yelling at me and let me work this out, okay?
No, you stop it! Why do you question every little thing I say? I'm goddamn sick of it!
I'm gonna try and get to you and pull you up.
Now, will you please get me off this goddamn tower? Please, 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 Matt, just do something!
Save Emily.
I'm coming. Here.
Ah! Shit. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Matt!
I don't want to tip it.
This is gonna fall. Screw it, we gotta go. Could we have saved her?
Emily!
Hell gods. We killed off three characters. We've killed Josh, Jess, and Emily.
She wasn't up there?
I don't know. I didn't see her. She must have come down here.
I haven't seen her either. Did that just happen?
Damn it. What is going on around here?
I think there's like a ghost or something. I only found this.
Chris.
Step, what?
Chris, I just want to say what happened back there in the shed. I know how hard that was. Josh was your friend.
Ashley, and, stop.
No, I want to say, I mean, thank you. Thank you for saving my life.
Sure, Ash. Sure. I mean, I'd do it again. Of course. Ash, you all right?
Yeah. What the heck?
Something's going on. We've got a ghost on our hands too now.
This is so effed up.
They should have never used that Ouija board.
Wait a minute. Did you just see that?
Flip, there's a ghost.
Did I see what?
That, Chris, that!
What that was that?
It was like a see-through shape, like a ghost.
Oh, boy.
I'm serious. Why don't you believe me? I said I saw it. Doesn't that count for anything?
We've been through hell tonight, okay? Your mind is fried. My mind is fried. I don't even trust what I've been seeing.
I saw a ghost. Yeah. It was definitely a ghost.
No, you are wrong. I saw it, and I am sure, Chris.
All right. Maybe you did see something. Let's just keep our heads.
Are we going crazy down here?
It's the only place left Sam could be, Ash.
I wish we could just go find everyone else and...
What if Sam needs us? What if she's in trouble?
Oh, God.
Let's go.
Oh, God. Does he not find it weird that doors are opening and closing on their own? Chris, stop running ahead. One of us is probably going to get killed. Forever Shaka.
How did everything get so freaky around here? Doors slamming and candles lighting up out of nowhere, and that specter. Look,
Ashley,
look,
I think you're kind of ignoring what's really happening here. See what? It's tiny furniture?
No, it's a whole scene with dolls and everything.
Yeah.
Lenotina, ding dong, ding, ding dong.
Wait, Chris, the ghost!
What?
Didn't you see it?
No.
You were looking at your phone, you dip. What are you tweeting? Hashtag there's a freaking ghost after us.
Ash, calm down, okay? There is no ghost here. Ghost of what? You're freaked out because of what happened with Josh.
You're not paying attention. I saw it. I saw a ghost, and it looked like Hannah.
Wait, what?
Her baby's bad.
Jesus, Ash. What do you think? They followed us up here from the seance?
I don't know. Maybe.
They didn't, because ghosts don't exist, okay?
Oh, okay, who was talking to us at the seance, Chris?
I don't know.
What did that?
How does a picture just jump off the wall like that?
Maybe a ghost? It's a key. So it's the key to the dollhouse, isn't it?
Huh. Here you go. Oh my god! There! Look there, Chris! You can't tell me!
He saw that one!
See?
That's,
You do see it!
Yeah, I don't know. I just... This is fucking crazy.
Chris, it's showing us the way.
Okay, that door's locked.
This is unbelievable. I feel like the ghost wanted me to see this.
What? Whoa. What is going on here?
Oh, God. It's like...
It's not like anything. That's us. Hiding there, waiting for Hannah. Last year.
How would you know, Chris? You weren't even involved.
Exactly where I was sitting, and that's where Matt was.
This was set up by someone who was there.
Or someone, or something that was watching us.
Maybe it's a warning. I think someone put this here to mess with us.
No, it has to be the ghost. It's trying to tell us the maniac killed Hannah and Beth.
I think it's this bastard that he's here trying to fuck with our heads.
Why would he set this all up, Chris?
He's trying to tell us that he's gonna come after us all too. Dice!
Now that was creepy. God damn it. That was creepy, yeah. One sec, guys. Okay, let's continue. Status and collectibles. Hannah's poster, Beth's poster. You mean with his best face look? Weird in that photo. She looks like she's already dead. Save yourself. Matt jumped to safety. Matt fired the flare to signal for help. Emily gave the flare gun to Matt. Okay, let's carry on.
It's Hannah's diary.
Oh no. Mom finally agrees. The invitations are out. The party is gonna happen. I hate that I have to wait. So far, Ash, Matt, plus Sam have said definitely yes. Nothing from Mike. Oh my god, Mike confirmed. He phoned Josh this afternoon. Love, Mike. Woohoo.
Party time. Everyone being together here on the mountain is going to be so awesome. Cozy fires and hot tubs and OMG, Mike. I am so psyched to spend some time with him. I can't read this. It's so sad, Chris.
Tony's got to stop obsessing.
What was that?
Came from down there.
That door was just locked.
Oh!
Oh my god.
God damn it.
Oh, Greg! Greg!
Nothing.
But you did see it, Chris. For real.
I saw something.
Oh my god.
Where'd it go?
Just when you think it can't get any creepier.
Oh! Jeez!
That shake, I think that was I think that was the fire,
Chris,
the fire tower falling.
I want to keep going. Where in the world are we now?
Are you kidding me?
Did you know this was here?
This is like a whole other hotel. I had no idea this was here.
I don't think I can take any more of this.
Yeah, I'm about at my limit here too.
All I wanted to do was forget last year ever happened, and
to be honest, I'm not sure what Hannah thought she was doing.
Yeah, well, you know how it is when you're crushing pretty hard on somebody.
Great, so you're basically saying that we put a vulnerable friend in a terrible situation and essentially caused her to run away and never to be heard from again.
Chris, you were passed out drunk. You couldn't have done anything. Hannah overreacted. No, you did make it look stupid.
If it was you, don't you think you would have run away? I mean, who likes being made fun of?
People don't make fun of me.
To your face.
Oh, the burn!
Chris, we made her look so stupid in front of all of her friends and the guy she liked. I can't imagine doing anything worse to somebody.
You mean you did? Chris didn't do nothing. What? Fake newspapers.
Hey, these. Are these fake? Why would anyone make fake newspapers?
That's a really good question.
True.
No, I've had enough. I'm not going down any further into this nightmare, Chris.
Ashley, I understand, okay? I'm really freaked out too, but if Sam's down there all alone with a maniac and we leave, we're basically killing her ourselves.
True. Yeah, let's find Sam. Let's find Sam.
God damn it.
Ashley, come on.
Why are you always right?
I'm not always right.
Well, when you're right, you're right.
I don't want to be. I want to leave.
No. We've got to find Sam. Let's go.
Yeah, let's go find Sam.
Chris, I'm getting a really weird feeling from all this.
What do you mean?
Well, I can't shake the feeling that those fake newspapers have something to do with the guy who killed Josh.
Wait, like what? Like it's a setup or something?
Yeah, but I mean, how? It's just, it almost makes sense, but it just feels like we're missing something.
True. I'm starting to like Ashley a bit more. But I still like Chris more than Ashley. What's in the rooms? What? Batteries and timers. TV lights. Wait. Let me go back.
Check this out, Chris. It all looks fairly intricate.
Yeah. Batteries, timers. This is some real secret squirrel stuff.
Oh my god. Do you know those things like where the lights came on and they went off and the TV? Maybe it was timed. Whoever this maniac is, he's trying to make it look like there's a ghost, even though there isn't. Unless the ghost of Hannah really is walking around. What's that noise? What's this?
That's us.
Why's Ashley got her eyes scratched out? So confused. Oh my god. But Josh is dead. And Jessica. And we think... Oh no, Emily isn't on here. Josh and Jessica are both dead, and Mike might be too. So why is Ashley the one with crosses? I mean, she's still alive.
I mean, wait, what is this, like a fucking hit list? Christ.
And why aren't Emily and Matt on there? What is this?
Hello?
Oh my god, I can't believe you actually did this.
Chris, it's from last year.
I just think this is a little bit... Oh, come on.
Stupid prank.
Oh no.
This is a little uncomfortable, huh?
She's here.
I've never seen this video. She's just so...
So what?
She's so excited.
It's Hannah.
And alive.
Hey, Hannah.
Oh, God.
She has no idea.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, my God. She's here, Cheryl.
I forgot you were such a willful participant.
Matt, what are you doing here?
It was just a prank. Yeah, I couldn't...
Oh, God. This is horrible. Couldn't feel worse.
Looks like you were enjoying yourself.
That's the worst part, isn't it? We were just playing a joke. It was supposed to be funny.
Yeah.
I never want to see this video ever again. Oh.
Well.
Oh, Chris. What is going on?
Ash, slow down, okay?
I can't handle this. Ghosts and these videos and everything just flying.
Calm down.
Around.
Listen to me for a
what?
Second.
What? Calm down? Why should I calm down, Chris? I am freaking
this
out.
This has
right got to
be someone messing with us.
What?
Think about it. Ghosts don't hook up video cameras.
True.
They don't play games.
Then who would set this all up? Seriously, I'm asking.
I don't know. Maybe the same person who tied you up and killed Josh?
Yeah, right.
The same person who might have Sam right now.
Maybe you're right.
I wish I wasn't.
Okay. Oh yeah, we're not Chris, are we? We're Ashley. God, I thought it was Chris. She's a little too charitable, it says here. Why has she got less of a relationship with Josh? Because he's dead.
Oh, crap. Look at that.
What?
Might be Sam's. All right, let me see if I can get this. Yeah, I got it, but... Oh, damn, this thing is heavy.
Be careful.
You gotta come through, Ash. I can't hold it. Come on!
Chris!
Wait, what?
I think I just saw Sam over there.
Ash, are you sure?
I don't know, but come on, I think we should check it out.
Well, I'm pretty sure whoever's bleeding came through here, okay? So we really gotta get moving, like, now.
Follow Chris, yeah. We gotta stick together.
Okay, yeah, you're right. I'm coming.
Oh, thank God. I thought this thing was gonna crush me. Come on.
Okay. Stick together, yeah. Ashley read as he was in the workshop, but she followed Chris. Ashley didn't take the scissors. What scissors? God.
I don't get it. Why would anybody want to make this place any cooler? It's freezing.
I don't know what goes on inside this guy's head, Ash.
Are these pigs? Wait a minute, I thought we kept Sam safe. We escaped. Sam escaped.
Oh, Chris. Oh, no.
Hello?
Sam?
It's not Sam.
Sam!
Shit.
I don't get it.
It's a dummy.
Yeah, no, I can see that.
Why is it dressed up like Sam?
I don't know.
Why would someone dress up a dummy like Sam?
Chris, I don't know, and I'm kind of freaking out.
Where the hell is Sam?
This is crazy.
Oh, no.
Oh, shit! No!
Ashley had no defense against the psycho. Oh, so if we would have got the scissors, she could have, like stabbed him with them or something. I found a dummy in Sam's clothes. Sam made all the right choices, okay. What is this?
Oh, shit. Oh, crap. Ash? I'm gonna murder his fucking face off.
What is this?
This is the guy who killed Josh.
No, God!
You murdered Chris. Piece of shit!
You monster! We're gonna die, Chris. I don't think I'm ready to die.
No one is going to die.
I wish I could tell you. It's just not fair!
What? Tell me what?
It's too late. Chris, what's the point?
Stop it. Just say.
We're always talking around it. And now, I mean, we've wasted everything.
Ashley, none of it was wasted.
What do you mean?
Every second that I spent with you was the only thing I ever wanted to do with my time.
Aww.
What are you saying, Chris? I'm
sorry.
They like each other, don't they?
I should have told you how I felt.
Chris.
Ashley, I swear when we get out of this. Oh, God!
No time for love.
Ashley, I'll get you out of this. I won't let you die.
Hello there, my special little subjects.
Oh, shit.
Don't be scared.
Oh, you should be, Ash. Because here's the twist. Chris has made one fatal choice already today. And now, he must make another. Chris. You can take that gun in front of you and shoot Ashley, or you can shoot yourself. Whoever is left can live. The choice is yours. Don't be so silly, Chris.
Oh gosh. Wasn't there like a totem about this? I got all these new clues. No, I wanted to have a look at the totems. He puts the gun down. Okay.
Brian! No! Oh my god! No! 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 Brian! 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 No! No!
Maybe that wasn't a good idea.
Don't you see? Huh? Don't you see that this torch of porn has gone too far? Huh? Now, what gives you the right to play God in these people's lives? What makes you so special then? Huh? You're sick! You're a sick fuck! Now, what the hell have you done to them? Huh? What the hell have you done to them? Psychopath. Psychopath!
Previously on Until Dawn. Well, guys, I think I'm going to end this episode here. Whoa. Now, that was an intense episode. Chris didn't shoot Ashley. Well, I don't know. This has been a very intense episode. So let's have a look at the bonus content. The score. I think that's what it said. Yeah, it's the score.
Alright, from the top.
Jason Graves, and I'm the composer for Until Dawn. I've been involved with Until Dawn for about a year now. Originally, I was contacted by Barney Pratt, the audio director. I think that had something to do with my lineage of horror games, and hopefully not the fact that my last name is Graves, although a lot of people seem to associate my name with scary music.
Okay. Cool. Okay, guys, so, very intense episode. But I would like to end it here, guys. Remember to like, follow, comment, remember to like, comment, follow, and subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time, Ultimates. Goodbye.